Yes, it is.
So we're not talking about that. We're talking about the upper aquifer, the water table. That's what we're talking about.
If you've got water on the surface, like you seem to want to have, it's a lake. It's not, you can't have a water table above the groundwater, sorry, above the surface of the ground. That's a lake.
And I agree with you 100%. So go to borehole 5 and tell me where the level is, and it's above the ground. That's what it says.
If you made comments in the past that when they dug the stormwater management pond, it was dry. It was dry, but then it filled up from seeps because of upward hydraulic pressure. There's water in the bottom of the stormwater management pond right now because of upward hydraulic pressure. It's not flow in from surface. It's groundwater that's flowing into the stormwater management pond. That's the upward hydraulic pressure that we're talking about.
So if I believe that, and this crowd believes that, that means they believe that it moves through that aquifer at more than half an inch a year. They must believe that.
Ladder.
So but it doesn't, according to all the specs. It says it can't move through that aquifer faster than half of an inch, or 11 millimeters, I think it's in the
air. There's a difference between laterally and horizontally. Sorry, vertically. The upward hydraulic gradient is vertical. There's cracks that make it move horizontally through the sidewalls. And you quoted 700 meters a year?
750 meters a year within the upper aquifer.
Mm-hmm.
That's in the upper aquifer.
That's the very surface material. That's not at depth.
That's right down to where, the day I was with you, to where we found the bottom of the roots. That's where the upper weathered zone goes to.
What's the depth of the stormwater management pond? Do you remember?
Not off the top of my head. A couple of meters.
Yeah, so you're
pardon me? A couple meters?
The bottom of it is a couple meters.
To the forebay? The base of the forebay, where you thought?
Yeah.
That's not that good.
Fine.
I'm just going off your measurements. Your measurements. Obviously, there's some confusion between the upper and lower aquifer, the confined aquifer and the upper aquifer. I think Linda had said that the movement in the upper aquifer was slow. Well, it wasn't slow, that's why I said it. It's in the records that have been approved of the MOE, 750. That means the water that's in the upper aquifer is moving in the fractures. That's, and all these new root holes and things like that. That water is not under pressure. It's never under pressure. The water in the confined aquifer is underneath that lower aquifer and pushes up, moves through, if we believe the numbers, at half an inch a year. You never see that water. You don't see it. It just pushes up. And if there's water in the upper aquifer in the base of the cell, then that's continuous upward pressure. That's you're realizing the potentiometric pressure. If there's no water there, it can't be realized.
Then where did the water in the bottom of the stormwater management pond come from?
Okay, borehole 5 said it was just above the ground, what we were standing on. There was water in the upper aquifer, and it was moving in the ground. It's just naturally there. It's not coming from the confined aquifer, because you told me that. You said it only comes through at half an inch a year. We would never see any water. Half an inch a year. It's a year, not 5 days or a month.
Borehole 5 isn't just surface water measurement. It goes down into the lower aquifer.
Four different tubes go down, that's correct.
Two measurements. You're not measuring just the surface, you're measuring the water down below.
Four different measurements.
Yes.
Two from the top, two from the bottom. They're isolated.
Borehole 5 is nested just four wells in a row.
Yes.
I think at this point, we'll wait for next month. The comments come back. I think it's worth healthy discussion and worth pursuing. There's no question about that. But we get our development involved back and forth and engaging.
Well, what we're hearing is very interesting.
Absolutely.
The cost last year, so bringing the total to $13,700,000 and some odd $1,000.
Okay.
It's true that we are paying $2,000.
That's right.
Okay.
And $2,000.
So, as a minor cost, what's your definition of a minor cost? Or what's your definition of a minor cost?
Well, things like the overwiring, things like the seating, not anticipating other major costs.
No, but minor issue. I've got a dollar figure worth of minor cost, dollar figure wise.
So, any one of them to be under $10,000 by comparison to the
$15 million.
Yep.
Hmm.
So, So what has been spent on Safeway when all told?
That's the $13,710,227.
So you spent
the end of 2009.
Well, Mr. Chair, you spent roughly $3 million last year at site.
$3,430,000.
And the year before you spent $10 million?
No, that's going back.
Okay.
Yeah, right. Including property purchase and everything like that. That in front of me as well, I don't believe I would put it anywhere close to those terms. The majority of the costs that are in front of you are for the tri-party meeting that was done in order to try to provide that sort of knowledge, provide that information to the CMC, to independent experts, and through the MOE. So I find it very difficult to characterize it the same way you have.
Well, it was for the mod vote that you were trying to satisfy the CMC back then.
We're trying to provide that access to
it. So
it
did drop.
This is the cost of providing access to it, not the cost of keeping access from it.
It's the same way when you read it.
I found very much that some of the information is being lost in translation, and some of the comments made this evening bothered me. We all know that the tri-party report, the model that was used that day, was not the original model. So to continue to say that was held up as showing us the model is inaccurate. I think also with this question that Mr. Austin brought forward about the dollar amounts for withholding the mod flow were wrong. So I'm sorry, Mr. McCullough, but you've become an unreliable resource for information.
That's right.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. In an administrative environment, there may be someone who is doing their job in a thorough method. And I'm wondering if it would be a possibility of having the hydrogeologist from the MOE come to the CMC so we can present to her our issues with the boreholes in 4-1 and 4-2 and make her understand why we've been so getting upset about not getting, we feel, accurate information regarding this, especially over a long period of time. I know you're not a hydrogeologist, Mr. Athron, and I'm wondering if it would be a possibility for the hydrogeologist from the MOE to come, because we feel that this is violating the CMA and the fact that it does not have upward gradients. We've impacted wells locally that I don't think is appropriate that you ask a fellow staff member about a well that was owned by her father. I think that shows...
So, your question is, you'd like to see an MOE rep?
A hydrogeologist.
At the next meeting.
That has been submitted reports to this committee that we have questions about.
That's a fair question. Mm-hmm.
I can make the request to see if either Ross or Hunter is available.
We know the answer.
We know the answer.